As I said in some previous videos, the sideload of apps belongs to the open source nature of Firefox OS, which is the heart of KaiOS. All KaiOS devices can be enabled to install third-party apps, as long as ADB debugging is enabled, or at least the development tools. Based on the difficulty of the procedure, we can classify the KaiOS devices in three types, of which the first two are almost the same. Type 1 devices. Nokia 8110, 2720 and 800, Alcatel Cingular Flip 2 and Mountain Smart, for now. With these devices, just type the debug code. Hash number 33284 hash hash. A bug icon must appear between the indicators at the top, at which point you should be able to get access to ADB and Web IDE. If the icon appears but you are not able to get direct access to ADB, your device should belong to the next category. Type 2 devices. Some devices, including Positivo P70 and Energizer E241s, and perhaps the entire Energizer series, after obtaining the debug symbol, can enable USB debugging from Log Manager or directly after typing the following code. Hash number 0574 hash hash. Warning. If you are unable to pass the first phase, you will most likely not be able to proceed to the next one. In this case, your KaiOS device will belong to that closed category of devices that I classified in the third type. Type 3 devices. The only way to get the jailbreak and the root for these closed devices will be to use tools that work in EDL mode, as in the case of Jio Phone and CAT B35. The same goes for Alcatel MyFlip by TrackPhone and Doro 7060. The procedure is more complicated, but at the same time it is universal and safe. In fact, in EDL mode, firehose is compatible with the chipset of your device are loaded. All you have to do is patch the data partition to enable ADB and development tools, or even include an app inside it, like Omni SD or Wallace, to do the privileged factory reset. Not all is therefore lost. The KaiOS devices are all configurable to the maximum, just be in possession of the right permissions. Type 3 devices are certainly the least friendly for less experienced users. Just think to my videos on the Nokia 8110 and compare them to the DIY video to understand how easy it is to configure Type 1 device and how is hard to do the same on a Type 3 device, in both the cases to getting the most out of it. If you are able to operate in EDL mode, you will be one step closer to being able to change the entire software of your device, having almost direct access to the hardware part. You might be able to also install Android using this system, even if this hypothesis would not fit on a hardware as weak as the one needed to make the very light KaiOS work. But that's another story. If you want to know more, subscribe to this channel and visit our website bananahackers.net. If you have valuable information to help the KaiOS user community in the search, do not hesitate to leave comments under this video. Thanks for your attention. See you next. BananaHackers.net. Join the revolution.